Good evening and welcome once again to our Office of Vespers at this traditional hour of 6 o'clock. We come before the Lord in the ordinary time now. We're in green, I believe, since the first time since Shrove Tuesday. If I'm wrong, someone will no doubt correct me. But it's been a long time that we haven't been in green. Ordinary time, the colour of growth and new life. Tonight we remember that the Pope has asked us to pray a particular intention for each day of May with our Blessed Mother Mary. And we will join his intention with our intercessions during Vespers intercessions this evening. We come now to praise the Lord, to thank him for all the blessings of today, and to also say sorry for the things that didn't go so well, where we didn't come up to our standard of our calling at baptism. But nevertheless, we are in the hands of a merciful Father, and he's always ready to forgive us. And so we keep going. We keep going. He encourages us to keep going, to grow ever closer to him. That's what he needs and that's what he wants. So this evening I'm singing the hymn for Vespers, which is in the Breviary and also in Universalis. So we come together for once this evening. And we start, as usual, with our at the Angelus, the greeting of the Archangel Gabriel to Our Lady. And we end with the evening anthem to Our Lady, the Salve Regina. So we start now with the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glories of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. La day is done, but love unfailing dwells ever here. Shadows fall, but hope prevailing calms every fear. Loving Father, none forsaking, take our hearts of love's own making. Watch us sleeping, God our waking, be always near. Dark descends, but light unending shines through our night. You are with us, ever lending new strength to sight.
One in love, your truth confessing, one in hope of heaven's blessing, may we see in love's possessing, love's endless light.
I will bless you day after day and tell of your wonderful deeds, O Lord. I will give you glory, O God, my King. I will bless your name forever. I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. The Lord is great, highly to be praised. His greatness cannot be measured. Age to age shall proclaim his works, shall declare your mighty deeds, shall speak of your splendor and glory, tell the tale of your wonderful works. They will speak of your terrible deeds, recount your greatness and might. They will recall your abundant goodness. Age to age shall ring out your justice. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessing. They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your might, O God. To make known to men your mighty deeds and the glorious splendor of your reign, yours is an everlasting kingdom. Your rule lasts from age to age. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I will bless you day after day and tell of your wonderful deeds, O Lord. The eyes of all creatures look to you, Lord. You are close to all who call upon you. The Lord is faithful in all his words and loving in all his deeds. The Lord supports all who fall and raises all who are bowed down. The eye of all creatures look to you, and you give them their food in due time. You open wide your hand, grant the desires of all who live. The Lord is just in all his ways and loving in all his deeds. He is close to all who call him, who call on him from their hearts. He grants the desires of those who fear him. He hears their cry and he saves them. The Lord protects all who love him, but the wicked he will utterly destroy. Let me speak the praise of the Lord. Let all mankind bless his holy name forever, for ages unending. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The eyes of all creatures look to you, Lord. You are close to all who call upon you. Great and wonderful are your deeds, O Lord God Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O King of the ages. Who shall not fear and glorify your name, O Lord, for you alone are holy? All nations shall come and worship you, for your judgments have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Your ways are just and true, King of all the ages. From the letter to the Romans. There is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free from the law of sin and death. Christ died for our sins, that he might offer us to God. We repeat, Christ died for our sins, that he might offer us to God. In the body he was put to death, in the spirit he was raised to life. Christ died for our sins, that he might offer us to God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Christ died for our sins, that he might offer us to God. Remember your mercy, O Lord, according to the promise you made to our fathers.
My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Remember your mercy, O Lord, according to the promise you made to our fathers. God's love for us was revealed when God sent into the world his only Son, so that we might have life through him. We are able to love God because he loved us first, and so we pray, Lord, help us to love you and to love one another. Jesus forgave the penitent woman her sins because she had loved much. May we too know his healing touch and love you with all our hearts. Lord, help us to love you and to love one another. You look with compassion on the humble and contrite of heart. In your goodness, turn our hearts to you and help us to do what we know to be right. Lord, help us to love you and to love one another. We acknowledge the suffering we have caused to others. We ask forgiveness for our neglect and indifference. Lord, help us to love you and to love one another. We ask you to remember tonight those who are in great difficulty. Give new heart to those who have lost their faith in man and in God, to those who seek the truth but cannot find it. Lord, help us to love you and to love one another. Remember all those who put their hopes in you while they lived. Through the passion and death of your Son, grant them the remission of all their sins. Lord, help us to love you and to love one another. The Holy Father, Pope Francis, asks us to pray each day of May a special intention. With our Blessed Lady today, we focus our prayer on this 28th day of May on the Black Madonna of Tottering in Germany. And the intention is for the Holy Father, for all bishops, presbyters and deacons. Elizabeth offers thanks to God for the safe arrival of Annabelle's baby early this morning and asks for our prayers to continue for that baby's strength and fortitude in a difficult time ahead. Prayers for Isabella Veldman and Josephine Bisniknik, who will be received into the church before their first Holy Communion reconciliations this Sunday. Prayers for all the first Holy Communion children making their first reconciliation next weekend. And for all those who in the first Holy Communion are receiving their communion for the first time this weekend. Those are from last year, prevented from doing so by the lockdown. We continue to pray for Carol Pickett for her continued well-being at this time. We pray for James and Danielle, married yesterday at St. Edward's Church in our parish. We pray also for Nick and Kat to be married tomorrow at St. Edward's in our parish. We continue to pray for the good health of Father Thomas on his break. We also remember one of our diocese's seminarians who's now a deacon as he moves towards ordination to the priesthood this July, Stephen O'Brien, and his ordination as a priest on the 4th. We remember our own two men who are moving towards the diaconate, which will take place on the 9th of July. We pray for all the faithful departed this life, particularly those who have died through this pandemic, particularly those who have been denied their last comfort with their loved one before they died in hospital. We ask for the healing of all those who are bereaved. Let us pray as our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God of power and mercy, who willed that Christ your Son should suffer for the salvation of all the world, grant that your people may strive to offer themselves to you as a living sacrifice and may be filled with the fullness of your love. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We close our liturgy tonight with the evening anthem to Our Lady.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules Filii Eve,
ad te suspiramus, germentes et fentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, Virgo Maria.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.